Amelia Mamir, this was due on the 9th of this month. Unfortunately, due to COVID, this is only going to be broadcast today. Today, we deal with outsmarting by contractors in construction projects. We'll deal with that today. There are general guidelines based purely on experience, and great care has been taken for the application of the following, as these cases can be considered as a precedent. It's always better to discuss with higher authorities and get their approval. Some of these are in conflict with established case laws. It is noticed that certain contracts, the contractors are aware that certain items have been omitted or changed during execution. These can be as small as a protection slab over the drainage pipe, or much bigger proportion that even the BOQ with approximate quantities status as a uniform document for pricing is under question. There were instances when the final quantities were inserted instead of tender quantities. The original lowest tender is no more the lowest, giving serious doubts about the whole tendering procedure in order to obtain value for money. Certain courts held that the BOQ rate should be take precedence in addition, omission or pricing of additional works. Maybe the courts were convinced that these rates are not numbers, have undergone analysis by consultants before the award, and adherence considered to be reasonable. It is the duty of the technical auditor to first establish that outsmarting or unethical practice were in fact taking place in pricing before proceeding to take these drastic actions. This is to be implemented on a case-by-case basis and not for global application. Unjust enrichment cannot be accepted in any case. But BOQ rates are not reliable for the use as basic rates for changes. The non-use of available BOQ rates as a base for pricing of varied works when the original BOQ rate is very high. In a project, it was noticed that the capacities of the air conditioning equipment were changed during the implementation. A general pattern of underpricing was noted in the equipment that was in tender and the subsequently omitted. This resulted in a substantial increase in the variation. A new pricing mechanism was established on the basis that the actual change in prices between the present capacity to that of the original capacity with necessary overheads and profits were agreed as a variation. Electrical cables were drastically changed during execution of the project. While the pricing, the variations, it was noted that the cables were priced very high, around 300% market price, which resulted in the high amount for this variation. This led to many discussions, and finally it was agreed on the similar basis as the above. More cables are tendered at actual price, but price with market rates, difference was given as a variation. In another project, the contractor has underquoted the entire electrical items. During the execution, the entire electrical items were changed owing to the service requirement, to service authority requirement. The contractor priced all electrical items as variation based on market prices, which were accepted by the engineer, as these were new items not expected at the time of tender. The end result was the change much lower cables are very much higher than the higher size cable in the tender. The new prices of lower capacity distribution boards were very much higher than the higher capacity ones in tender. As an amicable solution, BOQ prices were given to distribution boards as the capacities were not increased, so there is no justification for high prices as these were not new items. Similarly, the prices of new cables cannot exceed the price of the next higher grade cable in country. For example, the price of 25 mm cable cannot exceed the BOQ price of 35 mm cable as the specification remains the same. Non-feasible BOQ rates in relation to given PC rates in tender or manipulation of PC rates. The engineer has to identify the PC rate items and make necessary arrangements with the employer in order to know backdation can take place. A mathematical formula with only one variable, purchase price, which is given in the annexure can be used for adjustments. Very small quantities in tender which are priced very high and the quantities increase drastically during implementation. Such cases should be noted during the analysis of tender and the contractor should be made aware that such rates shall be applied for tender quantities only. Any additional quantities should be based on new reasonable rates. Addition of work after award. During the post-tender negotiation, owing to budget restrictions, certain items were removed from the lowest tender and the project was awarded. These removed items were not analyzed during the award of these, as these were not in the scope. It so happened that these rates were very high when compared to others. The removed items were given to the same contractor as variation, resulting in heavy loss to the client. This is a bad practice. Scope to be clear. Variation should be avoided. If there is a possibility for that item of work to be done later, you should have undergone analysis and the variation should be based on such adjustable or reasonable rates. Relying on contractor staff, conflict of interest. There is a tendency for the consultant to rely on contractor land survey, for example, for all levels, as some consultants do not have land surveys. There are possibilities for cheating, and the amounts can be huge in roads and park projects with heavy earthworks. Non-contractor cooperation. There are instances where contractors tend to request for extension of time for the slightest a problem in order to cover their own delays. Recent case studies such as ruling the float belongs to the project, whoever gets there first can have it, indicated that the contractor also has to play an active role in successful completion of the project. Provisional sums. Provisional sum is considered to be a prescription of the tender documentation, meaning zero value is the best tender document. In practice, these have come into existence and in some contracts, there is a big percentage, sometimes in excess of 25% of the project cost total. There is a place for the contractor to insert his markup for such provisional sums. Some contractors do not price this and they forget conveniently. Sometimes arguing that they are unaware of the scope of the project, of the work. Provisional sums are generally not considered in details in the tender analysis for the award as there is no guarantee that the same shall be used. In the end, when these amounts are used by external parties, the main contractors get markup. Sometimes no input at all or very little input if any. There is a serious case in contracts where substantial amounts are given under provisional sums. One way of mitigating this kind of play is to analyze the provisional sum in detail, whether the same shall be used in full or part or not at all, the contractor's markup, etc. before the award. Experience has shown that the attitude of the contractor before the award that is more willing to compromise as there is a possibility to lose the project altogether. It's much more difficult after the award, often termed in the construction circle as a different kettle of fish. Play with the specifications. The present day market, equipment and materials are meeting the same specification but with price variation depending on the country of manufacture. Even products from one country assembled in another country has a big price difference. For example, made assembled in Japan versus made in Japan and assembled in Malaysia. Needless to say, there is room for play in such situations. Gender design is not applicable to construction. In certain design and build projects, particularly in steel structure projects, there is a tendency for the contractor to submit the price with certain parameters, which is sometimes some form of over design. During implementation, the correct design is used. As the consultant is more interested in the structure and the construction, meeting the technical requirements, there is a tendency to ignore the original design, which was used for the pricing purposes. The possibility of similar situation in other construction, for example, swimming pools. There is a wide difference in criteria for swimming pools, as there can be for a villa, for a school, or even for Olympics. Use of mathematical formula for the weight of steel instead of actual weight. Payment for rebar weighs in remesher contracts is generally based on a mathematical formula, as it is practically impossible to use the actual weight. There is a substantial saving in projects where heavy reinforcements are used, if there is a possibility to calculate the actual weight, as there are underweight, relatively higher carbon composition steels available in the market, and the same is used. Use of excavated soil instead of sewage soil in parks. There is a requirement for certain depth of sewage soil under vegetation. Some parks do have a series of mounds. There is a possibility to fill these mounds with excavated material and then the required depth of sewage soil, but build the same entirely filled as sewage soil. This is a double loss to the client, as the excavated earth is claimed as disposed of site, whereas the same is used in claiming for filling. Road pavement thickness not meeting the requirement. In some road or other pavement construction, by meeting other requirements, do not meet the specific thickness or the reduction is not within the acceptable tolerable limit. Some engineers rotate the exact same and ask the contractor to remove and relay as per the requirement. Some engineers accept same with the reduction of price for that particular item if the same can be used as the same meet other technical requirements. Technical auditors should check these kind of works, as there are possibilities for malpractices. The same is applicable for interlock types, as the thickness can be 6 mm but claimed 80 mm, as both on the surface look alike. Manipulation of invoice. In certain contracts, particularly repeated nature, say housing scheme, there are possibilities for change. For example, changes of iron mongering. Some contractors, with the help of suppliers, inflate the prices of items where these were increased in numbers and reduce other items to make the final figure the same. The total price in the quotation and the invoice is the same, but detailed pricing is manipulated. The employers can lose a lot on this type of fraud. Double handling, haulage. Double handling is not allowed in contracts. However, in certain projects, particularly in build-up or congested areas, there is a necessity to pay for double handling. There are possibilities for contractor fraud. Therefore, a correct system to be established in such projects and the same to be followed. Manipulation of PC rates. The PG rates for the supply of material or equipment are given in the contract in order to bring some sense as the material equipment available in the market with big price variation, although meeting the same specification. This may be due to the country of origin. Sometimes the project from the same country but assembled in another country also has a price difference. Sometimes contractors front load certain items of work and underquote items of work which are done during the latter part of the contract. There is a possibility that these kinds of front loading are not considered in subsequent adjustment of PC rate. An example below to illustrate the point. In a major housing project, BOQ item is given as follows. Supplying fixed ceramic tiles to the floors as per specification. PC rate for supply of tiles DIRHAM 15 per meter square. The same was priced as 17 meter square. The accepted overhead and profit for the contract is 12%. The actual purchase price of the tile is 10 per meter square. The contractor has given a saving of 15 minus 10 equal to 5 per meter square. This was accepted by the engineer as it looks all right on paper. The detailed study of the case resulted as follows. This BOQ range is not feasible as the BOQ item includes the wastage, labor, plant and other materials and overhead and profit, which is 12%. This will result in a negative value for labor and plant, as the same should have been priced elsewhere. So the new method has to be employed using a mathematical formula 1.03 into m plus k over y into 100, as there is a wastage of 3%. The wastage is 3%. M is the material. Is the purchase price of the material. K is for labor and plant and other materials. Y is equal to 100, that is overhead and profit. The new rate is arrived at 11.15 meter square. Therefore, the saving should be 17 minus 11.15, that is 5.85 per meter square and not 5 per meter square as given above. The difference is priced elsewhere in the contract. Alternative offers. In some tenders, there is a provision for the submission of alternate tenders in addition to the specified price. There is a tendency for the employers to accept the alternative tender without studying in detail, as it is lesser to the final value. There are possibilities for tenderers to submit such offers with lot of qualification, resulting in serious difficulties during implementation. Thank you.